May our prayers come before you, O God, as incense, and may your presence surround and fill us, so that in union with all creation, we might sing your praise and your love in our lives.
Amen.
You don't know me. I was just a voice in the crowd. Yes, my voice was one of those shouting out, "Crucify him." You don't know me, but you probably blame me. And of course you have good reason, but you don't know me. Then again, maybe you know me better than you think. I'm sure it's hard for you to imagine how Jesus had ridden into town with a cheering crowd lining the street. But when he was on trial, the only crowds to be found had turned on him, called for him to be killed, and even to release a murderer in his place. There's no excuse for it, but maybe I can help you understand how that could happen. You see, our people had been longing for freedom for hundreds of years. We had fought wars and battles and sneak attacks the whole time against Rome, yes, but also against other empire after empire that had occupied our land for hundreds of years. Some of us thought that Jesus was coming to lead the next and final revolt, the one that would drive the Romans away. We had heard of his great power, the whispers that he was the Messiah, God's chosen one. So when he didn't show signs of raising an army, and he didn't plot to overthrow the Roman rule, some of us turned against him. We wanted the other Jesus. Maybe you didn't notice. Barabbas, who we called for, his name was also Jesus. Jesus Barabbas. And did you know that Barabbas means son of the Father? Jesus Bar. Abba. It was easy for us to call for Barabbas, to have him be set free, because he's no mere murderer. He was the freedom fighter we had been waiting for. He had killed in the cause of insurrection. Jesus Barabbas would be violent for us, while Jesus the Messiah would not. So we got caught up in the rally, the mob scene, yelling terrible things, because we thought we needed someone to fight for us. I was wrong. I am guilty. But I have a feeling that maybe we weren't the only people in history that wanted to use Jesus to give victory to our side, to destroy our opponents. I was wrong. I am guilty. But I have a feeling that maybe other people have also gotten caught up in a mob mentality, willing to believe lies, shout slogans that serve somebody else's agenda, because it made them feel powerful for a moment. beat the enemy. Maybe you've had times where you didn't understand Jesus' way, where you just didn't want to follow him. The thing that I've learned through all this, though, is that even though I'm guilty, even if you're as guilty as me, God still loves you. God still loves me, the one crying out, crucify me. God didn't want me to shout out for Jesus to be crucified. But I'm pretty sure that God knew when a mob of people get together, they would do something like that. Because it's what people do. We get scared. We get selfish. We get fixated on the idea that being somebody else will make our lives better. I think God knew what would happen. That Jesus knew it was inevitable. That it was part of his journey to the cross because he had to suffer the result of this kind of sin in order to forgive it. In order to overcome it. You know me, but God loves me. And I believe that Jesus forgives me. You will never know me, but you may know me better than you think. And even when you or I get lost in the power of death, the power of fear, I know. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
Thank you. merciful God, source and ground of all goodness and life, give to your people the peace that passes all understanding and the will to live your gospel of mercy and justice through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God, remember us in your love and teach us to pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.